We begin tonight with a spectacular light show over San Diego this weekend as residents were able to see the northern lights right here in Southern California. And there's still a chance that you can catch it for yourself. Our Christelle Kumwe joins us now live in studio with this rare phenomenon. Christelle.
It is very rare, and many people chose to go straight to the mountains to catch the best views. Now, today I had a chance to speak with one San Diego resident who said he spotted and captured the beautiful lights from Mount Laguna.
Lucky viewers enjoyed a once-in-a-lifetime sight. Many of you sent us pictures of the breathtaking view as the sky turned a brilliant electric shade of purple, pink, green, and yellow hues. The Aurora Borealis was caused by a strong geomagnetic storm that hit the Earth this weekend and was visible across the country and throughout California. The solar storm is the largest to hit the U.S. in over two decades. Photographer Vishwash Lokesh captured the colorful display from Mount Laguna Friday night.
I think about 11:20 is when it really picked up and we were able to see bright pillars. It was like mind-blowing for me.
He shared some of the great shots he got.
I want to show you what I started with mm-hmm. and then how it progressed in the night.
And says none of these were edited.
Basically, so it just lit up like crazy. So we were able to see the green and the horizon, and then like it was pink and then a little bit of purple, but the purple was really faint to the eyes.
Looking at that, it was like really amazing. I didn't have words to talk. It was really amazing.
Pragati experienced the moment with her husband. But what if you missed it? This is NOAA's Aurora forecast for Sunday night. Areas in red have the greatest chance of seeing the northern lights, while those in green and near and above the red line have a slimmer chance. The chances are also slim for us here in Southern California on Monday. For Vishwash, this was a once-in-a-lifetime sight he'll never forget.
You can always take a flight to go visit like Alaska to see some things, or go to Puerto Rico to see bioluminescence, but seeing at home makes it really special for me.
Now, northern lights are not usually visible in San Diego County, making them a very rare occurrence here. And it was quite amazing, as you could see with all these pictures.
Okay, maybe I missed it. Where were they exactly?
They were in the eastern, like the mountains is Mount Laguna, Borrego Springs. That's where you could catch them. Just stay away from all the lights, the clouds and things like that. And that's the best place for you to catch those.
Beautiful images. That was incredible. It's almost like you don't believe it's really
going
to happen, especially because we've been so fogged in here
Absolutely.
At the coast. Did you actually get to see them?
I did not get a chance to see them. However, thanks to our wonderful viewers, I had plenty of pictures to look at.
So great. All right. Well, thank you, Christelle. That was absolutely beautiful. So what are the conditions looking like tonight? Is there still a chance, you know, it's only 10 o'clock now, to see these northern lights? Let's check in with Sarah Legre with that part of our coverage. Sarah.
Hi, Misha. Yeah, the chances tonight looking a little bit more slim, but still a chance that you could see it. Like Christelle said, if you travel to eastern San Diego County, you'll have better chances at catching a glimpse of all of this beautiful imagery. And really, if you change the exposure settings on your phone, you could potentially capture it through that. If you add it up to like 10, there's a better chance that you could catch it at least through your camera's lens rather than the naked eye. But I want to talk about how this even happened in the first place. Well, we all begin with Earth and then Earth's magnetic field. So what's been happening is the sun, the solar winds kind of infiltrating that system. We have these charged protons and electrons that are emitted from the sun and then cause this whole disruption to the Earth's magnetic field. What happens then is those particles follow these lines here and then cause this entering in the Earth's atmosphere where the field is at its weakest, which is the poles. But what we saw with this geomagnetic storm, it was able to get into even deeper parts of the atmosphere. Those electrons collided with a bunch of molecules to nerd out for you and do all the science aspect of kind of why we're seeing what we're seeing. It's just the sheer intensity of this geomagnetic storm that led to us here in San Diego even being able to catch a glimpse of some of the action. So tonight, if you wanted to catch one final shot of the beautiful northern lights here in San Diego, You have a chance to. Here are the temperatures in Fallbrook. Temps in the mid to low 50s, but more so where you're going to see this, like Christelle said, eastern San Diego County. We're talking away from all of the light pollution, places like Borrego Springs and Mount Laguna, where temps in the deserts in the low 60s, low 40s, though, for Mount Laguna. Misha?
All right, Sarah, thank you. Man, you did a great job explaining that. That is just so fascinating.